Who knows what evil lives in the heart of game? The Shadows knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadows Knows, and I'm back with another pickup video. I've been to the... I've forgotten how the Retro Birth was called. I have the World of Retro Gaming in Stevoort, Belgium.
Was the 7th edition.
And I was there with my mate Tomaniac.
Hi there again.
And yeah, we did not as many pickups as usual, but I think there are some interesting things among them.
Indeed, some specials.
And as always, we go from the oldest system to the newest, and my mate Tomaniac has some Atari games, so he is about to start this time.
So, yes. I have two all in all, but the second one is special. So first I start with a game I've searched for a long time. It's Fathom, where you control a dolphin and have to collect stars, sea stars? Seesterne?
I have no clue how they are called in English.
Yes, but it's a really cool game I played often in my childhood, and now I found it for rather cheap. I've seen this much more expensive, something about 60 euro, and I got this one for 15. And then I have a real special one. It's a, it says 32 games in one, but what's special here, it has dip switches on the back side, and so it depends or it controls the game. Here we have the name of the games, I hope it's readable, and how you have to set the switches to start the game, for example, or switches up position is helicopter wars, and all switches down is baseball. And so it contains boxing, mathematics, freeway, flag capture, tank street, don't know, golf, ski run, chess, oh, boring, outlaw, rabbit jumping, parachute, six funny doll. So I hope this isn't
what?
Six funny doll, not sex funny doll. This would be more interesting.
Six funny doll.
Basketball, fishing crab. I hope I haven't fished crab. And bowling, cannonball, RC battle, 3D tic-tac-toe, meh, tennis, Othello, meh, bingo, meh, surround, cowboy, blackjack, meh, beach morning, okay, eagle, laser blast, salt racers, I think this is a mistake and has to be slot racers, silver fox, space castle, and baseball. Okay, this.
Yeah, but
so it's really interesting this to have these switches. I've never seen something for the Atari before of that kind. I've seen them for the Game Boy, for example.
Yeah, but this is, method is much more reasonable than the Atari 32-in-1 cartridge, where you have to turn the console off and on 32 mm-hmm. times to get to the last game. Mm-hmm. So. You need a little bit more intelligence to operate this, but it's much more convenient if you have the intelligence.
So I really look forward to test this out. And I'm still...
You're still...
Okay. but we can make a good transition then to this. So, I got some Commodore 64 stuff. And it was complete in a box, and the seller said 10 euro for all of that. So I took my part and gave some cassettes to the Shadows Knows. So, and this was a big package, and it was for 10 bucks. And I don't know what these games are about, or if this all are games. And the first one is Neoclips. And then I have...
This is a Defender-style game, by the way, for the
C64. The Equalizer. Don't know what this is about, but it says there's a free audio track follows the game. So there seems to be an audio track at the end of this game behind that. Don't know. Then we have Quattro Racers from Codemasters, and it contains 4 racing games: BMX Freestyle, Championship, Jet Ski, and on the inside, ATV Simulator and BMX Simulator for the Commodore 64. And then I have, it's written in, is it Belgic or is it?
It's Dutch, it's football. Dutch.
Yes, football, but it's written in Dutch. So, but I think you can't go wrong with football, and it shouldn't be too hard to control.
This is a football manager, not a football game. So,
okay.
Be aware that it might not be too much fun.
Okay. So, but back in the days, I like to play these football manager games. Also,
I also played them, but
the very easy made ones.
I think I had one from the Input 64 magazine.
I remember there was a basic game where you saw the ball, but it wasn't a ball, it was a square, moving to the right and to the left and so randomly, and then so, goal or not. So then I have Fighter Pilot. Really look forward to test this out. And then this later. Don't know what this is here. Bulldog. And
I think it's the game Feud from Feud. Bulldog, and not the game Bulldog
from Feud.
There is a game that's called Bulldog, but I don't think it's Bulldog was one of the Mastertronic labels, and the BSF and the style of the label indicates that it's a Mastertronic game in the end. And I've heard about Feud. Can't tell you what kind of game that is, but I know that Mastertronic released a game called Feud.
And this cassette has a nice label, Commodore Computer, but it has nothing on the cassette itself. It's blank. And also there's this is blank, but hey, there's standing something. Lichtkrant. I don't know what this means.
And my Dutch language skills fail me on that. So I know I have some Dutch viewers, so please translate this for us.
So, and then we have... it seems to be a tutorial for the Commodore 64. It's written in Dutch, but I think it's something like a tutorial tape. Does it say something on the inside? But it's written in Dutch, so it's Dutch only. But I don't know what this might be about. To get to know the Commodore 64, I think. And some basics. Yeah, how to get into the Commodore 64, but it's written in Dutch.
So it's for people who never had a Commodore 64 before.
I definitely will try this out someday, and I hope I can understand something. And there we have a similar thing. It's called Dossier Commodore, and it has different programs on the tape, also written in Dutch. I hope he can focus this, and it's readable. So you can pause the video and try to read BBS Letterbri. CD assembler, CD disassembler, disk file 2000, NUARC version 2.1, and break it. Topless, huh?
What?
Topless. Game number 6.
Topless.
Data Speeder, Checksum, CD News, Ballettje, Revolver Held, Memory, Talk, and Eve version 1.1, and Tune Simulator. Doesn't say anything to me, but we will see sometime. And this is are the tapes I have, and there are some more concerning programming or some basic knowledge.
We come to that later a little bit.
But before that, I got a bunch of floppy disks full with games. Games with no names. They belong to R.E. Huygen. Spellprogrammers. So, yes, and this is perfect for my YouTube videos I do. I pick randomly pick floppy disks out of a big boxes I have at home. Most of them are donations, and so I get surprised every time I pick out one of these floppy disks and try them out and look what's on them. And I really look forward to try this disc out. They are in a good condition, and I think they are still readable after all these years. And yeah, we will see. And all this and the ones the Shadows knows will show you together were $10, €10. So, okay, it's your turn now.
First of all, because Tomaniac doesn't like Spy vs. Spy, I got Spy vs. Spy.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try to make a little bit of room here. Then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, this also 6, 7. 7 tapes from the Dutch Public Broadcasting Institution, the NOS, the Netherlands Omroep Stichting. Basic Code. This was, how do I explain Basic Code? It's like a compatibility layer to run the same basic programs on different machines. So there is a translate, some of those tapes are translator tapes. So they provide a compatibility layer. So you can run the same code on an MSX machine, on a Commodore 64, on a Spectrum, on an Amstrad, on an Apple, and I think even on an IBM PC. Basic programs, all those tapes full of basic code programs and the proper translator program for the different systems. I will probably have to do a video about this tapes one day. And there's also Wegweis op u new Commodore 64 Versi 2.0, also so it's version 2.0 of basically it's probably also introduction tape for the Commodore.
It's also written in Dutch.
It's also in Dutch, but it's from the Microcomputer Club Nederland.
It says horoscope on page on site 2.
Yeah. I will try those out someday, and Leerwereld, this is two educational games, also from the Dutch Microcomputer Club, and this is a little bit weird, Glühwe, Belastungsprogramma, and I think if my Dutch doesn't fail me, this is a text program. MSX on side one, Commodore and Spectrum on the other side. So please, all my Dutch viewers, please translate this for me. I think it has something to do with taxes. And also there was this MSX game, complete in box, Jet Bomber.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a little bit lying. It says English manual there, but Nederlands Handleiding, and it only comes with a Dutch manual, but I don't think it's...
It's complete in box, and I don't have an MSX, so I gave it to him.
And the MSX, and this is from Arcsoft, and Arcsoft is a Dutch company, so I think the Dutch manual is the appropriate manual for that. And I also got this one, that was not in the box anymore, but I got... This joystick, it's a Philips. As far I did a little bit of research, and it was made for the Philips VC5000 computer, which were, to my knowledge, only released in France. And yeah, it has some weird screws at the bottom. I think the one screw, the AB screw, you can change the behavior of the fire buttons if they are independent or the same. I haven't figured out the function of the other screw. So if you know this joystick, please write in the comment what they do. It does not feel too well, but I only paid $2 for it, and it's a proper MSX compatible joystick.
You can't have enough controllers.
you really can't have enough controllers.
Yeah.
Especially the ones that support two independent buttons on the MSX computers, because that's used quite often there. And I think you have to continue, because my next newest one is the PlayStation.
Yes, the next ones are the first standalone Famicom games I got. The other ones I have at home are multi cartridges, 240 in one for the Famicom. And these are the first ones, single games. I haven't found on multi cartridges yet. And the first one is Image Fight. And this is a shoot 'em up. And I really like such shoot 'em up games. I'm a big fan of them, though I'm not really good at them, but I really love to play them. And the other one is something like a mech fighting horizontal shoot 'em up game. It looked really good. We have seen this on YouTube, and then I bought it. So I don't think you need Japanese to play these games. It's Volgaard 2, the name of the second one, and I really look forward to play them. These are the only two Famicom games I have, and the first ones, as I said.
Yeah.
And
I think collecting for the Famicom is much more interesting than collecting for the NES.
Yeah, because it's much all of these, cheaper.
Not only that it's cheaper, but those come in different colors, mm-hmm. and the shapes of the cartridges are not always the same as they are on the NES. All NES cartridges pretty much look the same.
Yes.
The Famicom cartridges don't. It's more like collecting for the Atari.
It's more interesting.
Yeah.
I've seen retro fairs or videos of retro fairs where the sellers have sorted them by color, so the box looked like a rainbow. And so this makes collecting interesting, I think. And then I got two Game Boy Advance games. The first one came with a nice case. The case has the look and shape of the first Game Boy Advance. So I think you can see this better. And the game in it is Tekken Advance. I have no plan how this looks like on the Game Boy Advance, but yeah. Why not? And the other one, it seemed to be a shoot 'em up because of its label. I never heard of this before, and I will take this out so you can see the label better. Or I'll open it. It's a Phalanx.
Yeah, and I think it is a shoot 'em up. And
yeah, I also.
The spaceship looks very phallic. It really looks like a penis with two boards attached.
Yeah, okay.
You know what I mean.
Yeah. So I think it might be a typical shoot 'em up and side scroller or something like that, and I really love to play them. And yeah, long time ago I collected games for the Game Boy Advance, and yeah, this time I found some. It was more a Mega Drive and Master System retro fare, what was a good thing.
Yeah, so
and really good.
And it was usually most of the retro börsen are in a sports hall or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
This one was spread out on multiple smaller rooms, and it was not very crowded.
Yes.
At first it appeared very, very little, but it was four or five different rooms.
Yes. As we saw the first room, we thought, what, that's all? And then we saw there are more rooms hidden in this complex.
Yeah.
And four or five different rooms full with games. And this was really cool location.
To all my German viewers, if you know the Retro Börse in Bochum, it's more like that than the other ones. So really, a lot of separate rooms. It was not very crowded,
mm-hmm.
which was not too great for the sellers, but I really prefer if the retro person are not too crowded.
Yes,
so it was nice for us, but yeah. The sellers, obviously, the more people are there, the more people buy things. So yeah, it's always a mixed bag, but I will definitely go to this one again. It was the first time we've been there. And it was closer than the other Belgian retro Börsen we visited. Not by much, but altogether maybe half an hour or so less driving is at least half an hour less driving.
Yes.
So it was really a nice retro Börse.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And though there were lots of Mega Drive and Master System games to buy, I only bought one. To complete my series of this pinball games. This one was missing. It's Dragon's Revenge. And this series is really great if you like pinball games. It's Dragon's Fury, and there's another one. Alien Crush, I think. Devil's Crush.
Devil's Crush.
They belong together. You can say, and it comes complete with the manual, and the cartridge still looks quite good.
Yeah, the manual has a little damage on
there was probably a price sticker or something, but the cartridge itself, it looks really good. It's in a good shape, in a good condition, and I'm really happy to have this one in my collection now and to complete this series of pinball games. Okay.
Yeah, then you also have PS1 games. So.
I have one PS1 game as a donation from him, and it's a role-playing game, and I really like playing role-playing games, but the problem at the moment is, they take much time, and I don't have that much time to play them at the moment, but I still collect them, and this is Breath of Fire 2, and this
three.
One three yes and the special thing here is it's complete in German, so this is not so easy to find, this German version, and it's a really cool donation.
Yeah,
thanks for that.
I fucked up while I bought this. I did not think that I did not imagine that there was a German version. So I thought I bought the English one, and when it arrived, I've discovered that it's in German, and I want to do a long play of this game. So and I do not want to do a long play of a German game in on my English channel.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
Not too pleasant for you, and I have to translate a lot since it's a role-playing game. So I probably download an ISO, or I have already downloaded an ISO and played on my modded PS1. So, I'll continue. I also got some donations from Domaniac. First of all, Gran Turismo 2, which is supposed to be a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Then I've got Strike Force Hydra, a shoot-em-up, a vertical shoot-em-up.
Vertical 2D shoot-em-up.
And I really like vertical 2D shoot-em-ups.
This is, as far as I know, you steer a boat. Something like River Raid, but sometimes you have to push the jump button because there are some parts land. So you have to jump over this land bridges from water to water while avoiding enemy fire and cannons and such. It's interesting, yes.
Then I have Patriotic Pinball for the PlayStation 1 to make the PlayStation 1 great again.
Yes. Well, not with this game, I think.
Pinball Power, and I love pinball.
Yeah, I also, but yeah.
Never heard of those, but better than no game.
It's a medieval setting.
Okay.
So
you
have to accept or to do fulfill quests and such.
Ah, okay.
Get experience points and raise in rank. from normal soldier to...
Okay, yes, in a pinball game.
Yes. Okay. It has missions.
Yeah, but
so
now...
this is interesting.
Now I have enough PS1 games to do another run of PS1 videos. Mm. Because I also got Revolt.
Yeah.
And that I've bought that on the retro burst, and it was not very expensive.
Yeah, I recommended this game to him because I played it to death on the PC already, and I also have the PS1 version, and I really love this game. It's really great.
Then I've got Mickey's Wild Adventure. It's a 2D platform game.
Yeah, it looks nice.
It really looks nice. Mm-hmm. And the Disney games always have very nice graphics.
You can't go wrong with Disney games, I think.
You can, if you... favor good gameplay over good graphics.
Yeah, okay.
But it may be a positive surprise. And I got Motor Racer, a motorcycle game, and they were cheap, so... And you got PS3 as next?
Yes.
So I can continue a little bit. I got R-Type Final for the PS2.
This is great.
Yeah, I hope it's
but
great.
But it's really difficult.
Because this was not cheap.
Just in the easiest mode, it's difficult.
If I practice, I'm not too bad at shoot 'em ups. I've got The Great Escape, where you have to, like in the movie, you have to escape from a German prison camp in World War II.
Das ist tatsächlich, ja, genau.
And I did not escape from Germany in real life, so maybe I can escape in a game. Then I've got Le Tour de France. This was very cheap. The price tag says $2, but they had a 20% discount, so I paid $150 for this. And since the Tour de France is going to start soon, I think this will get a little bit of views. Then I've got the Farming Simulator 15 for the Xbox 360. The game is in Dutch or French, two languages. I understand a little bit of Dutch, but I don't understand any French, but it was a Euro, so...
I don't understand both, and I made a similar mistake.
Yeah, it's not a mistake if it was only one Euro. It's.
I think so.
I've played one of those farming simulator games on the PC, and it's a farming simulator. So all those real-world stuff... simulator games are pretty shitty. And the last game I've got, I was quite happy to get this. It's Lollipop Chainsaw for the original for the Xbox 360. Mm-hmm. And I only paid a tenner for this. And I watched a video of this after Tomaniac picked up the PS3 version on the last video.
Last video.
And it looks really, really nice. So I'm looking forward to play this.
Me too. Okay, so then I can continue.
Yeah, you can.
Okay, so at last I have three PS3 games. And the first one, it's Rayman Legends. And it seems to be a real cool platforming, 2D platforming game. But this version is only in French and Netherlands. I hope... I can understand, but what is there to know on a platformer? So I think I will get into it. And
in worst case, you will not be able to understand the story, which is not very interesting anyway.
Yeah,
so.
Normally not. So the next one is Street Fighter versus Tekken. And all the games are complete in box with manual, and the discs look brand new. And the last one, to me, it's a holy grail, a hidden gem, Metal Jesus Rocks suggested this one. And so I started looking for that, and I've searched really a long time for the game. And finally, I found it, and it's called 3D.GameHeroes. And this is an action RPG. with yeah, the characters all look pixelized, but all the characters and the landscape and everything there is made of little blocks, something like Lego or Minecraft in smaller 3D pixels, as to say. And you have to do quests there and such. Return to the golden age of gaming and embark on a nostalgia-laden Pixel Heroes quest across vast 3D landscapes and mysterious dungeons to save Dotnia from the legendary evil. Create your own pixelated heroes and trade them with friends. Upgrade your sword by adding length and width until it fills the screen. And it looks really great, but it wasn't cheap. I've paid 45 euros for the game, but this was, to me, it was worth it, because it's a real great, a real cool game, and you don't find this often. I've seen this only once on this whole retro fair, and the last years I didn't find it at all. So I'm really happy to have this in my collection now. And yeah, these are my games I found there.
Yeah, I don't have any games, but I picked up two cheap DVD.
Yeah, we look forward to see this soon.
Yeah, we are going to watch this tonight. It's Balls of Fury, the Stoner edition. Never heard of it. And I've got the first season of Heroes. Yeah, Save the Cheerleader, Save the World.
Have you seen are they all in there?
I have not looked if all... I mean,
all empty.
No, I've... There are all seven discs, and I've looked into... Yeah, they're probably complete. And the discs I checked, yeah, they are in pristine condition. And the whole season one on DVD... Yeah, it's only on DVD. I have downloaded it back in the days on in HD. But... The whole collection of the season one was only 1 euro. I've already seen this on two or three retro börsen, and finally I picked it up because I think, yeah, the first season was really cool of Heroes, and I think it's definitely worth the 1 euro. Yeah, and
I really like Christopher Walken. I really like to see him. Yeah, he's a cool actor to me. I really like him.
Yeah, okay. that are our pickups. This time I did shoot some footage from the Retroverse, because it was not exactly the same as always.
It's not so common, yes.
Yeah, with the multiple rooms set up. So I will add this after right now, and let's see how this works out. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this quick pick of video, and thanks for watching.
Bye, folks. See you next time. Thank you.
Zit er nog in die
water. En daar zit op die stijl van 6? Ja, maar op.
Ja.
Okay. Das ist so ein Gelächter. Gibt es schon mal den Wagen? Das ist immer eine Nacht.